在1981年的时候，第十六世大宝法王在美国的伊利诺州圆寂。这个时候呢，不只是全世界的佛教弟子，连全世界的各大媒体都非常关心第十七世大宝法王究竟会投胎到什么地方，他会投胎到西方呢，还是会回到原来的西藏。
It was a state funeral, and mourners gathered from all corners of the earth. Karmapa has millions of followers.
He left behind four young representatives, or interim regents. Shamar on the right is the eldest. Situ on the left. Jamgon. And Gyaltsup, the youngest of the interim regents.
Rainbows over the blue skies of Sikkim. For Tibetans, a sure sign that an enlightened being has left his body. In Buddhism, death is not the end.
Karmapa died with the promise that he would again give a clear sign by which he could be recognized in his new life.
第十六世大宝法王对人类最大的一个贡献，就是把佛法带进了欧美。要知道，这个美国人啊，欧洲人啊，他们从这个科学的观念入门的这些人，他是绝对不肯傻傻呆呆地迷信佛法的，或是像渔夫渔妇一样跑去崇拜佛菩萨。所以他们一定是问了非常多的问题，要真正看到大宝法王以及跟大宝法王一起去的这些禅师们拿出了实修实证的例子来，他们才开始相信，他们开始相信轮回，相信因果。一本一本的书在大宝法王去了美国之后都慢慢开始出现了。像是大宝法王只去了美国两次，到美国各个城市去弘法跟举办法会之后，就像雨后的春笋一样，在几年之内在欧洲跟美国一共出现了几千个禅修的中心。那大宝法王也派了很多有实修实证的禅修的老师去那边带领美国人还有欧洲人修行。那在十六世大宝法王到欧美弘法的时候，发生了一件非常有趣的事情。当他到了美国伊利诺州的印第安保留区传法的时候，当时这个印第安保留区已经很长一段时间干旱了，大宝法王就为他们祈雨，在祈雨了不久，马上就开始天降甘霖，而且下了好几场大雨。这个也应验了印第安人古老的传说，当一位戴红帽子的人到我们印第安去来弘法的时候，这个时候东方跟西方会建立起一个非常紧密的心灵的桥梁。这件事情也应验了莲花生大师在数百年前的预言，当铁鸟升空，铁马走路的时候，西藏的佛法会传遍全世界。
It is said that the 16th Karmapa accepted his cancer out of love for the people of the West. He spent his last days in this American hospital.
Watching as a physician, an unstoppable illness ravages body, and yetThis kindness that never stopped. Every morning, I would go in and ask him, are you having pain? And he'd smile at me and say, no, no pain, no pain. It was very confusing to the staff. It was obvious he wasn't just denying his illness. So the staff was constantly confronted with this person who was dying, but was still more interested in how they felt than in how he felt.
Karmapa died on November the 5th, 1981.
His principal students invited me into the room and had me hold my hand over His Holiness's heart area. And each day I was amazed to find that it stayed warm. I wasn't as amazed after 24 hours, but then after 48 and 72 hours, I was beginning to be quite shocked. Traditionally, shortly after death, the body becomes cold as the circulation stops. And in His Holiness's case, there was a definite warmth over the area of the heart.As a physician, I have no explanation for this.